Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder.
Classes while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.
Thunder.
Welcome to Park Vista High School. This is our virtual open house. I'm Mrs. Bailey. I know things are a little bit different this year with social distancing and all, so we created this program so that you can sit back and learn all the same information as if you were here live from the comfort of your couch. So please take time for the 30-minute presentation here to learn about our four academy programs, our automotive collision, automotive service, multimedia communications, and our medical science academy. Thanks for joining us.
Park Vista High School offers a state-of-the-art campus and a competitive curriculum preparing today's students for tomorrow's careers. No matter where you live in Palm Beach County, students can sign up and attend Park Vista High School and be a part of one of its three choice programs. These programs allow students to earn college credit and receive certifications in their chosen field. They are auto collision repair and refinishing, automotive service technology, and medical sciences. In the auto collision repair and refinishing program, students get right to work.
We're gonna make a continuous weld right up in this area here.
This is a hands-on environment. Besides welding, students also learn about sheet metal repair, paint systems, and other trade skills.
It's overwhelming to know that they do get certified and they do have a career available to them in the auto industry.
In automotive services technology, Park Vista students work on cars at one of 18 computerized service bays.
Not many students in high school get to have this experience. We have a really big shop, a lot of tools.
And the teachers provide the students.
How worn out the brake pads are.
With the tools they need to succeed in the real world.
They are getting the experience, and again, they have to want to go and do this. And those are the students we're trying to get, the ones that sound like a car, they have oil in the veins, they're passionate, that's what they want to do.
In medical sciences, the emphasis is also on a hands-on type of training. Here, students learn how to successfully draw blood by working on a phlebotomy arm. This comprehensive program combines a rigorous academic curriculum with intense clinical and laboratory experience.
The best thing for me is when I hear they get into medical school or they're actually doing the professions that they learned about here, or they say to me, it's great that you taught me this, it's helped me so much in college.
For students zoned to attend Park Vista High School, they can be part of the multimedia communications program. Students here start with an information technology foundation and then move into areas such as computer graphics, web design, technical support, and entrepreneurship. Another aspect of the program is working in the TV studio.
Today's the last day to buy your senior videos for $5.
Students gather news, write scripts, and put a newscast together. As you can see, Park Vista has the programs, but what makes this school special are the people.
I like Park Vista High School because everyone's so welcoming and friendly.
We did it, Mike! Done!
I love Park Vista for the atmosphere, the people, the fun. We always have fun. We have a lot of spirit here.
It's like the teachers and the students here, like we're all like a family here, and it's just, it's so welcoming.
Everywhere you turn, you see Park Vista pride. Pride in the sports teams, pride in the clubs, the campus, and the classes. Yes, the students at Park Vista High School definitely have Cobra pride. The school district of Palm Beach County, your best choice.
Our automotive academies are split into two separate academies. Our automotive service technology program is basically dealing with everything under the hood. It's the engine, it's the wheels, the brakes, the transmission, everything that makes a car actually function. The second program is the automotive collision repair and refinishing program. And just as it sounds, it's dealing with the body. It's learning how to weld, how to paint, how to do other structural changes, how to deal with the insurance companies, and many other aspects of automotive. Now, when you go to apply for these programs, you can go ahead and apply for both. You can make one your first choice and the second one your second choice, but you're only going to get accepted to one. But that doesn't mean you can't also participate in the other. So if you get accepted to one, and once you get registered here at Park Vista, we can go ahead and then look at whether you want to take the other auto program as an elective option. Automotive is the only area where we do that, and it's depending on space and availability, but quite often it does work out for students so that they're able to take both down the road. So this year you would choose one and make the other your second choice, and then next year you would choose the second one, and we can go ahead and try to enroll you in both. I found this information from the National Automobile Dealers Association. As you can see, it shows that there are hundreds of thousands of jobs available for students who might want to work in a dealership. Keep in mind, these jobs include not only the technicians and the body shop people, but it also includes the salespeople, the human resources people, the finance people, the customer relations people. There's all kinds of different job opportunities in the dealerships. But dealerships aren't the only place where our graduates will end up. Many of them will go to private shops. There's lots of those throughout the country. And in some cases, our students will actually own their own shop in the future. That is a goal for many of them. Many of the students also may not even go into this industry specifically. They might just go into engineering when they go off to college. But the hands-on experience that they're getting while they're here will help prepare them for that future. So currently, the gasoline engine is still the most common engine you'll find on the highways. Yes, we hear a lot about electric and hybrid technology as being that of the future. So yeah, we will touch on that with our students in this program as well, so that they will be prepared to adapt as technology changes. Our automotive service program is fully certified by the National Automobile Technicians Education Foundation, or what we call NATEF. NATEF has professionals that come in every couple of years and they look at our shop to make sure that it's up to standard, that we are teaching the most current technologies and delivering the education that we have promised to our students. Along the way, students have the opportunity to earn certifications that tell future employers that they are indeed prepared to begin work in their facilities. Our students start with learning basic safety skills, but then all of the other skills inside an engine and with dealing with tires, transmissions, engine performance, and all those other skills are covered throughout the 4 years of the program. The automotive programs do not have a grade point average requirement in order to apply. Basically, any student in Palm Beach County is eligible to apply to the program. We're just looking for the type of student who really wants to be involved in cars. This is a 3 to 4 year commitment. They will have the class every day, so they need to really enjoy what they're doing so that they can be successful at it. The only restriction is for those students who live out in the acreage area and are zoned to go to Seminole Ridge High School. They also have an automotive service program. So it's an in-house program out there, so only those students can go to that particular program. So we would have to be a second choice if you preferred to come here. Auto collision, however, is not available out there, so anybody can join our auto collision program regardless of where you live. We also have our automotive club, which is open for students to come on Wednesdays. Many times they just bring in their own cars and work on their own vehicles and learn the skills that they want to do separate from the class. And our automotive teacher is always there supervising them and helping them out. And we try to get involved with field trips and bringing in guest speakers from a lot of post-secondary schools so that the students can see what opportunities are available once they leave our high school. We get calls every year from local businesses looking for students to fill jobs. A lot of the people that are in the automotive industry are aging and they are starting to retire. So more and more job openings are becoming available each year for students who have the correct skills. They usually have to wait until after graduation to actually go work in the shops because the insurance companies have age restrictions for people working in the shops. They want them to be 18 years or older. But, you know, that's after graduation. In the meantime, we do have retailers such as O'Reilly, Knapp, and AutoZone, and other places that don't have that age requirement. So we can send students who are interested to get those jobs now so they can work on their customer relations skills, work on dealing with all the different parts and organization, and get a little pocket money while they're still in high school. Our automotive collision program is the only one in Palm Beach County, so if you're interested in learning how to repair cars, this is the place to be. Just like our service program, there is no GPA requirement, and since we're the only one, anyone in the county is eligible to apply for this particular program. Both automotive programs have pretty thick textbooks because there's a lot of technical knowledge that students need to understand to be able to work safely in the program. They also have a lot of online practice programs as well, so they can get all of the safety skills in and get certified in those lessons. Beginning students will then learn how to use welding tools. There's different types of welding depending on the job, and welding can comply to a lot of different industries and not just automobiles. So students will get those skills first and then they'll eventually work into repairing the actual body and doing the paint work, learning how to assess structural damages and dealing with customers and insurance companies and all those different skills that are required of a collision expert. What do you think of this cute little car? It actually was quite a bit bigger in the beginning, and it had four wheels rather than three, as this one currently does. It's one that the students designed themselves. They took an older vehicle, they literally cut it in half and have rebuilt it and painted it and gave it graphics to kind of be their own fun vehicle. It's just a sample of some of the things that the students could be working on. In years 3 and 4, our automotive students have the opportunity to take the ASE entry-level certification exams. These exams focus on specific skills that they have been learning. They are given as an industry exam. We're able to do it right here on campus, and we pay for the exams for the students, so there's no cost to them. They just have to study, take it, and then take the credentials with them. They can show those credentials to future employers or attach them to their applications to post-secondary schools, showing that they've already earned a lot of the skills right here in high school. On the collision side, there are 3 different tests that they can take. On the automobile side, we have 9. Seniors in our service program also have the additional exam that they can take called the Florida Automobile Dealers Association exam. We're able to offer that one here on campus as well, and again, we pay for it, so the students just have to study and take the test. It is the industry exam. It is a little bit longer and has a lot more skills on it than the ASE exams. The ASE exams are very focused on just brakes or just steering and suspension. The Automobile Dealers Association exam is more encompassing of everything there is to know about mechanics of cars, as well as other skills that would be expected of people who work in a dealership. Our Medical Science Academy is highly popular among students. It did change a few years ago. It is now considered an in-house academy. Students still need to apply, but the only ones who can apply are the ones that are already zoned to attend Park Vista High School. There are 11 Medical Science Academies throughout Palm Beach County, so if you can't apply for this one, there might be another one out there that you can apply for. So just do a little bit of research and look on the Choice website so that you'll be able to see which program you can join. The first 2 years of all of the programs are basically identical, but it's the second 2 years that are a little bit different in each one, and you'll see here how our program differs from others. Each of the Medical Academy programs, like I previously said, are basically have the same 2 courses for the first 2 years. The Health Science, Anatomy and Physiology, as well as Health Science Foundations, are the core classes that teach students all about the different body systems, as well as the basic medical terminology that they need to understand before moving into clinical situations. It's the second 2 years where each school is a little bit different, and it's based primarily on the skills and the certifications that the instructors have. Medical is very specific, so if you are a pharmacy tech, you have to have a pharmacy tech certification in order to teach it. We don't have that one, but you can see here we do have nursing assistants, we have EKG technicians, we have emergency medical responder, medical lab assisting, and our directed study is a little bit more of a fun class where the students learn basics of medical forensics. Again, that's a pretty popular course as well. We also offer a medical dual enrollment. This course is actually offered through Palm Beach State College, so students can get college credit, but they don't actually have to go over there. They stay here with our own instructor who also works with the college. So there's a lot of opportunities right here in our school. Here are the industry certification exams that students take as they complete the individual programs. We have a very high success rate of students passing these exams. Again, they're industry exams, so they can take these credentials and in some cases go straight to work. Certified nursing assistant is one of those where students can actually go into nursing homes and some facilities and start working immediately. We've had some do it while they're going on to post-secondary education, and some do it and that becomes their profession straight out of high school. Again, these are all exams offered by industry. We pay for them. Students don't have any cost associated with them. They just have to study and take the exams. HOSA is our official medical club. We have a very large chapter here of over 100 students, and even some of the students in the club aren't even in the medical academy, but they have a strong interest in medicine, and this is their way of being able to participate. It's a very active club. They have a lot of charity events. They have regional, state, and national competitions, and it's just a whole lot of fun. They also put on an annual event for Halloween, where they turn our facilities into a haunted hospital. Our Multimedia Communications Academy is the largest academy we have here at Park Vista. We kind of treat it a little differently than we do the other academies. We don't even require students to have to put in an application. Really, all they have to do is sign up for the course if it's something that they're interested in. So the three programs that would be a part of this academy include the digital media program, where students are learning the Adobe software and graphic design. They get certified in Photoshop and an Illustrator, and they work with the Nifty organization to become entrepreneurs of businesses that utilize a lot of the graphic and artwork. We have our TV production class. They obviously do the announcements all the time, and they are putting together an additional TV program. And our last course would be the marketing principles and business ownership. Again, they work with Nifty, but they get into the nuts and bolts of really owning a business, learning all the different aspects of small shops up to bigger corporations. It's becoming a very popular class, and we have a lot of students in them. You can take each of these classes for the full 4 years if you like. And as I said, once you become the second year, you become part of the academy, and by the third year, you're eligible for certain scholarships. Like the other academies, we also have industry certification exams for students to take advantage of. This year, we are currently focusing on the Adobe, Photoshop, Illustrator, and Premiere. Photoshop and Illustrator would be part of the digital media program, while Adobe Premiere is part of the TV production program. Again, these are tests that the students can take here, but they are industry written exams. We pay for them, so all they have to do is study and take their credentials with them into future careers or just into their post-secondary education. The National Technical Honor Society is the official honor society of all career and technical education classes. So that would include the automotive, the multimedia, and the medical programs. As you can see, it's a little bit tough to get into the honor society. Students have to maintain a 3.5 GPA of all of their CTA courses from freshman year all the way through, and a 3.0 in every other course. At the end, when they graduate, the big thing that they really like with this club is getting those purple and white cords that they get to wear at graduation. But the society also recognizes their level of achievement, and they often get together and have some charity events and some socials as well. This choice transportation really only applies to students who are accepted to our automotive academies as an out-of-boundary student. Typically, you would have to provide your own transportation to get your child here, but it is possible to pick up one of the local school buses. You should probably call the transportation office at the beginning of the school year to find out exactly which is the best stop. I've included in here a link that you can go to findmybus.com on the school website, but keep in mind that that is just current information and bus stops change constantly. So I would just call the department at the beginning of the next school year. Okay, here's the real important stuff for applying to a choice program. You have to go through the school district website at mypbchoiceapp.com in order to make an application. That application site opens up November 2nd and will remain open until January 29th. So you've got some time to go in there and make your selections. You need to be sure that you live at the address that you put on that application during that window of time. If you are living somewhere now and you plan on moving in February, the move address is not going to count. It's where you are during that window of time between November and January, and it must match the address that is in SIS within the district. So if you've got to change something, then you need to do that immediately. The deadline is January 29th to get everything in, but if you happen to be applying to one of the art schools where you have to audition, such as Dreyfus School of the Arts or Boynton Beach High School arts programs, then you've got an earlier deadline of December 18th. So you've got to make your selections by that 18th of December deadline. After that, you won't be able to access your application anymore. Also, you do get one chance to change your mind. So say in November you pick one school and then in December you say, oh wait, I really want to do this other program and it's somewhere else. You can go in and change it. You just have to do it before January 29th and you can only do it once. So be careful when you make that decision. Then in mid-March or beginning of April, the district will send you an email, and the email will say whether you got accepted into the program of your choice or whether you are going to be placed on a wait list. If you got accepted, congratulations, and I will follow up with you with a welcome letter and required documents that you're going to have to turn in so we can get you registered. If you were placed on the wait list, then that's what you have to do, is wait. Really what happens with the wait list is after 2 or 3 weeks of time, when everyone else who was accepted has opportunity to put in their paperwork, there's usually one or two that change their mind again and they decline. So that would be the reason a seat would open up. It doesn't happen a lot, but really that's all you can do is wait. And if something does open, then we'll certainly let you know immediately so that you can be happier with the decisions that you're making for your high school career. The choice application does sync with the SIS system, so it knows where you live, and as a result, your application will only show you the programs that you're actually eligible to apply for. For example, maybe you're trying to get into our in-house medical program, but you don't actually live within our boundary. So our medical program won't even show up on your application. You won't see it. So if you're looking for something and it's missing, that's usually the reason why it's missing. You're not actually eligible to apply to that particular program. The other thing you need to know about is there's a button that says, I need transportation. If you click that button, it's going to limit your choices. So some of the programs that you might be interested in won't show up just because of the transportation issue. So you might want to click that off so that you can be sure you're seeing the full array of programs throughout the district that you might be interested in. And lastly, please be sure that your residential address is correct at your child's school. So log on to your SIS portal and make sure it matches where you actually live. If it does not, then you need to call your current school and get that straightened out. That is the biggest reason that applications are rejected, is because the addresses are not correct. It also needs to be correct because when we do start the registration process, we're going to ask you to send us documentation showing exactly where you live. And sometimes applications are pulled back because of residential address issues. So double check it, make sure everything is correct, and that will help the process go smoothly. Congratulations, you got accepted to one of our academies. If you get that message, then I'm going to be sending you a bunch of additional paperwork, and one of those pieces is the contract. The contract is a binding agreement between the student and the school, is saying that they will meet our expectations in order to stay in the academy program. Specifically, it says you must maintain a 3.0 average in your academy classes from beginning to end. Remember, an academy class is just one course throughout your school day, but you will have that academy course every year for the 4 years. You also have to maintain at least a 2.0 grade point average in all of your other classes. Now, 2.0 is low. That's what we require for graduation. It's not good enough for many colleges, so you want to work on getting that GPA as high as you possibly can by getting good grades in all of your classes. Then you also have to maintain your attendance and make sure you're not having any discipline issues. If any of these items are a problem, you can be removed from the academy. If this is not your home school, then you could even be removed from Park Vista and be sent back to your home school. So it's important that you follow the contract. When you get it, make sure you read it. There's lots of little details in there, and you'll be asked to sign it and return it. Well, that concludes this particular presentation. I do have a lot more information for you. If you want to go to our school website, click on the school info button, or actually right below there, there's a button that says academies. Just click on the academies and then you can click through the different ones. I have photo galleries where you can see more pictures of the different facilities and the students and some of the activities that are going on. There's some videos to watch. There's links to the industry certification exams. There's also a frequently asked questions page. Please read through that page if you have any questions. And then after you've exhausted all of that information, if you still have questions, please feel free to give me a call. I'm available between 7:30 and 2 o'clock at the number listed here, which is 491-8431. Or you can always send me an email at kim.bailey@palmbeachschools.org, and I will get back with you as quickly as I can with any of the questions that you have, so help you through the process. Thanks for watching, and again, check the website for more information, and good luck.